Hey, this is Deanna of Deanna's Crafts and Creations. I am here with my design team project for Country Craft Creations. I showed you in my last video the numbers that I had started for my December daily, and they're all in this bag. And I've finished the book. I've put all the base pages together so that come December 1st, I am ready to go. I'll talk about my supplies real quick before I do a flip through of the book. I, of course, use the October Afternoon Make It Merry paper collection. Really love it. It's got a nice vintage feel. Some quarter inch score tape and some 1/8 inch score tape. And then I use these magnetic discs, magnets from Basic Gray. These are great. So I mostly used everything from the collection. I barely have any pieces left, just a few scraps and from the cut apart pages. And when I started this project, I had a totally different thing in mind. I found a sketch online that I was going to use for all my pages. I cut all my paper into 6x6 because that's the size of my book. I cut some craft pages to use as my base pages. This is actually one of the pages that I've made from that sketch. But the other day when I was sitting down to finish this book, I decided I really didn't like that at all. So I had to come up with another plan. And I must say that I do enjoy this book better than my first idea. So I'm just going to flip through real quick and let you know what I've got going on. I used my Bind It All, and this is a coverall. It's 1 inch. I haven't decorated it yet. I usually do my cover at the very end because with the book and using it every day and trying to write in it, it's just easier to wait. And then, like I said, I use my Bind It All with the 1 inch rings. My pages are 6x6. The largest is 6x6. Some of them are smaller. This is one of the tags from the cut apart page. I use some Basic Gray stickers, which you'll see throughout. They were the letter and number stickers that I used. Wrote out 2014. And then I just put some stickles on this to kind of brighten it up a little bit. I don't know if you can see. Little sparklies in there. And then this side is lined, and I can make some little notes on there. This is a bingo card that I printed from the Silhouette. My printer was running out of ink when I did it, so it ended up kind of pink, but it matches, so I was okay with that. I used a Martha Stewart border punch to punch a border and glued it down onto the side here. I actually taped it using the score tape, and then I used the 1/8 inch score tape to adhere that down. I glued some index cards to the back. Well, I taped index cards to the back to use for my Christmas list, and this was one of the tags. I used some of those Basic Gray stickers, and it says two friends from the Goins. And I used some glossy accents on the hat and the nose. I just added a strip of washi tape right there. This flips up so I can write down the people I send cards to. And I have basically one day for each page. There are some days when we have, I know we have activities that will really need more than, you know, one page, so I've added extra pages in for that. If I come to a day and I find I do need more room, I can add a pocket or add some flip pages to make sure I have room in my book for everything. This I just left plain, and same with day two, I just left it plain. On day three, this was one of those pages that I had made from the sketch, and I had already glued the number down, so I decided just to leave this page as it is. And I already wrote a note. What I want to do here is just to list our favorite Christmas carols. When the kids are here, I'll ask them, and I'll just type it up and fit it in right there. And page four was a page that was already completed as well. So I just left it. This number four is glued down on the bottom. I'm trying to find something here. Just so that, you know, it's a little pocket type thing. So I can stick photos and stuff down there. We have a band concert that day, so there'll be some extra pictures, I'm sure. So that's why I did it like that. So I can just, you know, make some tags and tuck them in there. I used some stickles on the star. We will be decorating the tree probably on December 5th because we wait until my husband's kids are here to do that. This was one of the postcards from the collection. I'll just put a picture, you know, right here. The back is lined so I can do some journaling. And then I left this blank so I can fit a bunch of pictures on there. We also have a chorus concert later that night. So I used this music paper from the collection. I thought it was great for that. I used some crackle accents on the lamp. I don't know if you can tell that or not. And on the 6th is also another Christmas party that we're going to in the evening. This was one of the tags from the collection. And I just stapled a piece of lace trim on there. And I used the Martha Stewart border punch to punch the edge of this page. And I tied some cotton cord around it. I used that 1/8 inch score tape to run a line of tape right here, and then the front is loose so I can tuck pictures under there, and then I can glue that down at the end of the, after I'm done with those pictures. This was one of those pages that I had made already, and I tried to salvage what I could from it since I changed my mind, and this, you know, I don't know what we're gonna do that day, but I will find a picture to put there. And that's just another page. I just made a banner right there. This was one of the tags from the collection. I just punched some holes in it and added it in there. I can use it for extra space, extra journaling. I could put a picture on the back, whatever I want. This was, again, one of those pages that I pre-made. I have the number 9 already glued down, so it's a pocket like that, so I can tuck some extra stuff in there if I need to. This is another pocket page. This is one of the cards from the collection. I just rounded the corner, glued it down on the bottom and the sides so I can tuck stuff in there. I used glossy accents on the bow and on the berries, and then I put some stickles on the snowman and on the gingerbread. This, we have another chorus thing to go to, so I used some more of that music paper. I used another border punch to punch the edge on that. This is just a blank page. I will do something with that later. This is an envelope, just an A2 size envelope I put in here. This was one of the pages that I pre-made. I cut the cardstock part off and then just used the score tape to adhere it to the envelope. I can put a picture up here. I think it's a pocket. Yeah. So I can tuck some tags down in there. And if I have extra pictures from this day, you know, I can make some tags to stick them in the pocket. This was another page that was pre-made, and I just cut it and fit it on there. This one is not a pocket. And then I used the score tape again to put that piece of ribbon, that trim down right there. This is a coffee sleeve. I just cut the pattern paper to fit it, punched some holes in it, and I cut down a Tim Holtz tag to fit in there. I glued one of the tags to the front of this. I put some glossy accents on the bow, on the bells, on their eyes, and on the little ribbon around his neck. This was one of the cards, the kids writing a Christmas list. So I'm going to put the kids' Christmas lists in here. It's only glued down at the bottom, so I can just tuck everybody's down in there. And I use those basic gray stickers that says Christmas list. Another blank page. This was one of the cut apart pages. It was really narrow, so I added a strip to the side and used some red bling to dress it up a little bit. I've got glossy accents on the eyes and the nose and on the collar. And I have some K & Company transparencies that I've had forever. So I got those out and I've used a few of those in here. This says counting down the days and I just glued it down with glossy accents. I used one of the number pages and just cut some banners for the top. And this is it a pocket? No, this one's not a pocket, but this is one of those pages that I had started to make for the other album and then changed my mind. So I kept it and just added it to my book. This is another one of the cut aparts. I put some glossy accents on the eyes and the nose and on the buttons, and I used some stickles on the holly. I can do some journaling on the back. This is another envelope which I can put stuff in. On this page, before I glued this red paper down, I use some score tape to adhere this piece of trim. I just tied it in a knot and I left it open so I can tuck some pictures underneath it if I need to. When I'm done, I can glue that knot down with some glossy accents so it doesn't go anywhere. This is the day that we are going to get our pictures taken with Santa. We always take the dog to the mall and get her picture taken with Santa, and Sarah is 8, so she'll probably get her picture taken with Santa. Last year, David was 11, and he did not really want to do that, so he probably won't do that this year. But this card was narrow, so I made a little piece on the side so that I didn't really lose any of the picture here. I added some of that red bling to the side. This is a transparency. It says ho, ho, ho. And I put a red halfback flatback pearl on there. I used stickles on the white fur parts of Santa's suit. There's the back. I can put a picture here, which I'll probably put the picture of the dog with Santa. I just glued this card here with some, I taped it with some washi tape so I didn't want to lose it. One of the papers had the you know, that Santa story, which I cannot remember the name of it, but it has, you know, he had a broad face and a round little belly. So I thought that was great. I cut that part of the story out. I thought it was good for that page since that's our Santa pictures. One thing I always do for the kids is make snowman pancakes on one of the days that they are here for Christmas break. So this was one of the cards and it said Happy New Year on it or something. I cut that part off and I fussy cut out the image. I put some stickles on the snowman and I put it on the paper with some foam tape. I just put it on the outside so that I can tuck pictures under there. This was one of the tags from the cut apart page, and I used one of those transparencies, and it says the best gift of all. And what I'm going to do for the back of this page, which has the journaling lines, is I am just going to type up the Christmas story from Luke and just put that on the back there. It'll be a nice reminder of what the season is about. It's not all about getting presents. It's about, you know, the gift that we received. And we'll do gingerbread house one day. So I have this gingerbread washi tape I put down there on the bottom. I didn't put anything else on the page. I might add some more after I take the pictures of the kids. It depends what how many pictures we have. And this is a page where I use the magnets. This is our Christmas Eve page, which is when we open presents with the kids on Christmas Eve. I had these file folders. I covered the front with the pattern paper and put Sarah's name here. This has a magnet in the page so that it's not going to flop around, and I can print pictures and put in there. I made a hinge so I can put more pictures. So there's lots of room here. I'll probably do one or two single pictures, and then I'll probably print some 4x6 collage pictures to put in there. This was one of the cut aparts, and it said family traditions. So I'll put some of our traditions on there, which one of our traditions is we eat tacos for dinner on Christmas Eve. And that all started right after my husband and I got married. You know, when his kids are here, we have them up through Christmas Eve. So, of course, they want to open presents, which, you know, we don't do until after dinner. So they want something quick, and tacos are quick. So that's become our, you know, our tradition, Christmas Eve tacos. So there'll be a picture of the tacos on there. This is one of those transparencies from the collection. I just glued it down with some glossy accents and stapled a little piece of trim there. And I can journal about our tacos. I used another one of those folders, and there's a magnet in here to keep that down. And then on Christmas Day, we go to my family that live about 2 hours away. I'll put a picture here of my husband and I in front of the Christmas tree, probably. And this is a transparency from the collection from the Cane Company. I glued it down with some glossy accents just behind the that little holly image there, so I can tuck our picture under here. And some vintage looking people. I have no idea who they are, but this was one of the cut apart pages. I put some stickles in the snow so it's real sparkly, and I can put a picture back there or some journaling. This was one of the tags from the collection. I put some glossy accents on the antlers, their eyes and their nose and their hooves, and on the berries down there. And this was another transparency from the collection. I just glued it down with some glossy accents. And that's pretty much it. The rest of it's just some extra pages for some extra Christmas pictures, or if we do anything else for the rest of the month. I cut this page with the border punch. And that's the last page. And this is just the thing that puts it in the back of the coverall. So, you know, since I can take it out of here, I may go ahead and decorate this. I don't have much paper left from this collection, though, so I'm not really sure how I'm going to decorate it. But you can see it's a nice size. It fits the book just perfectly. So it's going to keep my book protected over the years. I probably won't put too much on the cover because I don't want it to get messed up. You know, I like for the kids to look at these when they come back over. I make them so that we can look through them again. I don't just want to put them on a shelf or in a box. Especially the Christmas ones, I like to pull them back out at Christmas and look through them. Well, anyway, I appreciate you taking the time to watch this very long video. And don't forget to stop by Country Craft Creations in Hooper, the Facebook page and the website, so you can keep up on all the great sales that we have going on. Thanks.